Next month marks 4 years since 12-year-old Tamir Rice was shot and killed by a Cleveland police officer. That officer was responding to reports of a black male threatening people at a park with a gun. And it turned out Rice was playing outside a rec center with a toy gun. But yesterday, 100 miles south of Cleveland, a Columbus police officer was responding to reports of two young black men allegedly waving a gun. And when that officer, Officer Peter Casuccio, arrived on the scene, he did not shoot. Instead, he tried a different approach that ended with a really important lesson, and it was all caught on his police body camera. Watch this.
Here's the thing. Are you scared?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You know why you should be scared?
Yes, sir.
This is getting kids killed all over the country. That thing looks real, bro.
I'm so sorry.
You should be sorry, and you should be scared. Do you think I want to shoot an 11-year-old?
Yes,
do you think I want to shoot a 13-year-old? I could have killed you. I want you to think about that tonight when you go to bed. You could be gone.
Again, that officer, Peter Casuccio with the Columbus Police Department, is with me now. Officer Casuccio, thank you so much for just being with me. And I just want, I mean, what a lesson for those two boys. I read that you said you went into dad mode. How do you mean?
Yeah. So I'm a dad. I mean, I have a child of my own. I have another one on the way. He's due in February.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. You have an obligation when you put this uniform on to take a parental role sometimes, right? If you have two kids in front of you and it almost ended in deadly force, you have an obligation as a steward of your community and to the men and women you work with to grab them by the ear and sit him down and say, "Hey, man, this is not the way it works. This is getting kids of all colors, from all different types of neighborhoods, killed, on a almost, I hate to say, it, annual basis at this point."
It is. That's the truth. And good on you for doing what you did. And I'm just wondering, do you think the majority of your colleagues would have done the same thing?
Yeah, I absolutely do. These types of encounters are not uncommon. BB guns, pellet guns, toys, and other replicas are readily available to kids all across the country. Unfortunately, as a young adult, you don't always understand the gravity of your decisions, right? You think that you might just simply be playing with your friends, or you're going to show off, or something you've seen on TV. You know, as a law enforcement officer, you have nanoseconds to make a decision, and I feel that out of my 800,000 brothers and sisters nationwide, they absolutely would do the same thing I did. Absolutely.
Have you, I'm curious if you talked to either of those boys' parents after this?
Yeah, so actually both parents responded, the mother of the 13-year-old responded to scene. He was actually on his way home from a football game. I mean, that's, if you want to talk about how tragic things could have been, that's how tragic they could have been, right? Here's a 13-year-old kid who just finished playing a football game and then is in a deadly force encounter with a police officer. His coach actually stopped. And I spoke with him briefly, and then coach called mom, and mom responded to scene and took the young man home from there. And the 11-year-old was, believe me, more than happy to walk home by himself afterwards. And I told him no. You're coming with me. We're going to go talk to mom about this. I think that mom needs to know what happened. And
yeah, she does. She does. She does. And, you know, not only do you did you do this, I do want to ask you before I let you go about Cops and Barbers. It's a community program. You started with your barber. What are you guys doing?
Yep. So Cops and Barbers is a program we do every fall. We take 20 kids this year. We're hoping to grow it next year. We eventually hope for it to be nationwide. You pair police officers with barbers in the inner city right before young men go back to school. We get them a haircut, and we provide them with the basic school supplies. The theory behind it is to give them a little confidence and help make them successful, because that's kind of what it's all about.
We need more Peter Casuccios in the world. Officer Casuccio, thank you so much.